Hello, Sarah from the Bureau with the latest on severe tropical cyclone Olga that currently sits off the northwest coast of WA. Now, we'll start off looking at the water vapour imagery as it really highlights with these bright colours here the high moisture that's being drawn into the centre of the system. Now, it's currently sitting around 400 kilometres to the northwest of Broome and is moving southwestwards, but it developed into a tropical cyclone on Saturday morning and quickly intensified, peaking as a Category 4 system last night. But it's been moving southwestwards and is now in an area that's not favourable for tropical cyclone development, so we're expecting it to weaken. So it's currently weakened to a Category 3 system, which means it has sustained winds near the centre of up to 150 kilometres per hour and gusts up to around 200 kilometres per hour. And as you can see, over the next couple of days, it continues tracking parallel to the coast and then weakens to a tropical low on Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. Now, direct impacts to the WA coast are not expected. However, as you can see here, there are some showers and thunderstorms and even some wind that will be brought to the Pilbara coast, particularly about the offshore islands. Now, there is a coastal wind warning that is current for strong winds, so winds up to 30 knots for the northern parts of the Pilbara coast. And that also for some offshore islands will be expected to be added over the coming days. Now, this is where we're expecting it to continue track away from the mainland and continue its weakening trend. So as I mentioned, we're not expecting a direct impact to the WA coast. However, we may see an increase in shower, wind and thunderstorm activity about the Pilbara. But it's really important if you do live within the area to start to date with our latest tropical cyclone warnings via the Bureau website, our app or social media. And as always, listen to all advice from your local emergency services. Bye for now.